this, not so much the design of the new Ken, honestly, his first character costume, his first outfit is not cool, but his kick specials, I really like his kick specials. So we're with JKO and Manon, and Ken, played by Primid.
I'm not a very good judge because I'm not at a very good. I don't play at a very high level, but I did play earlier and it beat me quite easily. So, no pushover, but I don't know in comparison. I did hear though he was complaining about. I believe he didn't like playing against Manon, so this might not be a matchup.
I can see from what we're looking at right now, Primit is playing Manon's game up close and personal. But Manon, okay, replied with the throw, but I guess, you know, Ken's like, okay, we're close, let's get close, let's box, let's go, you know,
exactly.
So
there's different dynamic in this one. Both of these characters don't really mind being close to each other, so.
Good quick throw break there.
Touch the throw, gonna block. Go for
it. Almost like judo throw just now.
Ken replied. Challenges. Going for parrying these fireballs. Plenty of good checking throws here is the big of the game. Now the green throws can't be checked because of damage. So keep that in mind. You are kind of forced to. Yes. Ooh, but. That must have been out of range. Okay, and the drive impact.
Yeah, I'm just impressed with how back and forth it's going right now. It's very close match. Ken
doesn't have too much
back against the wall. Against the wall, but he got his meter back. Manon's out of meter now. She's got a split up health. Back and forth as anybody in the game.
Didn't want to commit to another team might have chipped him out, but now we're out of that. We have to get a trade.
Yes. It looks like Primit and his team pulled it out. Whoa. Squeeze that one out. That's how you know they're pro fighters. You know, all they need is a sliver of health. Perfect carry by Manon. JKO.
Medals here in the first round.
One thing I commend about these fighters, they know when to use their meter, really good resource management there. You know, some moves come out with the fire, some moves don't.
If you do not manage your meter properly, when you get into burnout, you get really bad situation.
Ken playing with his pokes right now. Manon's trying to figure out how to get in. Ken's keeping her away. Ken,
drive impact.
Amazing counter going on right now.
You can react with the drive impact, your character will win that exchange. So if one initiates first, and then you initiate yours, yours will beat out
the other one. Yeah, that was some quick reflexes, quick, you know, player prediction right there. That's how you know we're looking at skill, high level play. Manon looks like she's playing Ken's game right now. Ken JKO's adapting to Ken's mix-ups and stuff.
Corner swap. We got it. Ooh, did not react to the drive impact. So that's going to be some damage here.
Ken's got to deal with that.
Four medals.
Good thing he has health to give himself a chance to make a decision. He's back out of the wall
in the corner now. Not much. Watch these. There's a lot. Ooh, but a fourth punish here.
Basically taking advantage.
Five medals. Now she has a round to spare here, but if we can get a hit, we can go into level three, and that'll be it. All the takes up. Okay, that'll do it too. One throw.
Wow, what a great quick game. This is a vicious round. One going to JKO and his Manon. Starting the round off strong with some kicks from Ken. Looks like a lot of production going on from both sides. They're trying to really keep hitting each other, read each other's movements. There's a protect that throw.
Happy to parry all day. Metal heal with this combo.
So, yep, the throw gave Manon a metal, making her more dangerous.
Still the first round, so any medals that Manon can get in the first round can pay dividends. It will last for that third round.
Oh, okay, he's doing the himself out. Big combo. Can he trim it?
Level one, get out of the corner.
Oh, a counter to reaction.
He didn't have any meter to drive impact, but was able to react with level one to get out of that situation. Oh, he's in burnout now. This is a very tricky. Oh, he
back
in that standing medium punch is in
hey,
burnout.
Hey, but Ken's still alive. Well, it looks like he's back. Another nail biter right here, guys. Another nail biter. Here it is. Oh my goodness.
Whoa!
A quick kick from Finn, and that's what he's known for.
A dangerous situation. You're in burnout against Manon. Standing medium punch. Continually looping because when you're in burnout, you're in block stun for longer, so it's harder to get out of that situation.
That's vicious.
Hopefully, oh, the drop combo. Missed the punish.
Whip the short you can afford. Manon. Break.
Corner carry is very good. It's very easy to suddenly be in the corner, even from mid-screen. That's the big risk of going through those command throws and a long recovery.
Ken wins!
Primid is now feeling himself.
Yeah, we got 1-1. We got 1-1 now.
Sometimes, you know, Street Fighter, a lot of games really, but Street Fighter especially can be very swingy. Once you things start going your way, you can sometimes completely flip the momentum.
So, oddly enough, there it is. That's my favorite thing. Ending that combo right there. I think that's new to this game. That specific thing. But, yeah.
I wish I knew. I've never played Cap.
Right. More prediction going on right now. You can tell just because they're spacing
corner.
Each other. Yeah, Ken's trying to get out of the corner.
And right straightly,
driver
straight into the and he blocks.
That took some mental awareness right there. That was pure prediction. Oh, I think 1-1. Yeah. Manon 1, Ken 1. JKO 1, Primid 1, yeah. Okay, a lot of spacing going on, but Manon, I think JKO Manon kind of learning Ken's game right now. Ken's trying to get from the start, he's trying to get through Manon's defense, but she's just applying with throws.
Throw here, oh, okay. He's not quite close enough to the wall to get slapped by that drive impact.
Now, I think I want to put Primit's game off or give out the strategy, but it looks like he's whipping on purpose in order to bring her in to get his combo started. But here it is. Oh, that is a guarantee. It's a major maneuver. All I've been seeing is him using that character to adapt to his opponent. And you see it in his gameplay.
The metal count really shifts the game too, because when you get Manon to a higher count, you have to really be careful when you're in the corner. So Ken has to choose his balance one sit to get the rest of the point. Good, the left is getting another metal. Plus, he's to drive in back. This will be pretty darn close to dead. So got a little bit of life left. That move, bringing it in, it puts you in a situation where you have to guess if Manon is going to throw you or if she's going to flip you with a normal. So
wow.
It's blocked. It's kind of a 50-50 now. The map gets a little bit different if you have option selects, but in general, though, you have to commit to some sort of position.
So, fresh round here. Yep. Getting fresh with the combos, bringing it down. Oh, all the way to the wall. Manon is still at the way. On this round, replies with a
This is going to be a lot of damage here. Look at that.
Wow, a lot of. That's
and
five metal damage.
Another one.
That's almost a KO.
That is the power and the drive impact. That is the power of five metal
Manon. Manon
wins! Rock it down.
I was like...
Hey, I've seen you play against you're really good.
Hey, Justin. All right, how are you thinking going into this grand final for the 16th time in a row?
I'm a little nervous. I'm a little nervous because I have to fight JP, but I think I can pull it out.
All right. Let's see.
I've been thinking about it. It's
Central Virginia versus, I don't know, where are you from? Let's go JMU. JMU. Here we go.
So that means he came out of the loser's bracket.
Yes, because Molson.